where the Appalachicola meets the warm Gulf waters, and pairs of oyster catchers raise their sons and daughters, and baby turtles crawl to the sea and swim the first mile on a long journey. They need Saint Vincent Island, rare and free, where wild things live in harmony.
Oceanographer Jeff Chanton and author Susan Cerulean are a married couple with intersecting professional interests. That intersection is physically located on Florida's forgotten coast and centered specifically on Saint Vincent Island. St. Vincent Island is a national wildlife refuge established as a 12,500-acre sanctuary for migratory birds. As storms threaten off the coast, we explored the wildest beaches in our area.
We first started coming out here about 20 years ago for recreation with our kids.
Just for the exploring aspects of it.
The wild aspect of it. But then about 10 years ago, the kids were gone. We had more time to talk, and we started just asking each other questions, mostly me asking Jeff questions about the same things you're curious about. How did this island come to be? What forces are affecting it? And we were already in love with the island and all the wild things here, so how will they be affected over the long term? That's when I started taking notes and putting together that book. It's been a good 10 years.
St. Vincent Island, let it be forever a sanctuary.
St. Vincent Island was created by climate change, sea level rise, and the Appalachicola River.
Sea level started rising about 18,000 years ago. Barrier islands didn't form until sea level kind of reached a steady point. It was rising very rapidly at first, and then it slowed down, and that's when the barrier islands formed. And unlike most barrier islands in Florida, this is a big, thick, fat barrier island, and that's because of the high sediment supply coming from the Appalachicola River.
But the island is disappearing.
Oh, this is a tree that used to live here. Trees like this, or any trees.
That's
a cedar. Don't usually live in the water. They're not as interested in waterfront opportunities as people are. And so one of the signs of shoreline erosion is to see these dead trees and turned over trees right in the surf.
St. Vincent Island is being consumed by the very forces that created it.
Greenhouse gas production in a warming earth causes the oceans to warm up, and when seawater warms up, it expands and it takes up more room. So that's one component of sea level rise. And then the other component of sea level rise is the melting glacial ice on land. And so both of those things combine to raise the sea level, and that causes erosion and retreat on barrier islands like you see here.
A network of dams and reservoirs in the Apalachicola, Chattahoochee, Flint Basin play a role as well. We often think of these dams in terms of the Apalachicola Bay estuary and oysters deprived of fresh water. But water's not the only thing being held back.
All those dams are going to impound the sand that runs down the rivers and makes up these barrier islands, and so they become sediment-starved or sand-starved. And I think both these processes might be important on this island.
Love the dolphins and the eagles and the shrimp and mullet. The pelicans are hungry for a fish in their gullet. From my small kayak, watching the plover, I vowed that I'd never let the fight be over. Keeping St. Vincent Island rare and free, where wild things live in harmony.
On the other side of the island, we meet John Stark, the refuge manager. He has some good news to share.
The previous record for loggerhead sea turtle nests was 104, and we had our 110th nest this morning, so this is a record year. We're pretty excited about that, and we're not into August yet, so we don't expect many more nests, but we do expect more nests. So this is very clearly a record year, so we're very excited about that.
Loggerheads, along with red wolves, and many of the migratory birds that stop here, are endangered or threatened. As St. Vincent Island changes, its ability to function as a refuge for these species will be affected. With that in mind, Jeff is pursuing a grant to measure the effects of sea level rise on the island.
There are no human habitations on this island. Basically, the ecological processes that are natural to a coastal island are taking place here. So it's a really perfect lab to look at the best scenario for an island.
To come here is to see Florida as it was and as it is in its most natural state for the most part. It's a fairly unique experience.
Saint Vincent Island, let it be forever a sanctuary.
Just made it. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.